Okay, so we talk about the time complexity of the Mars-Hot or the analysis of the Mars-Hot. So just to recap, in the Mars-Hot, what we are doing, we have this, we have a array of size n, and then we, if n is 1, we return, we are done. Otherwise, else we recursively sort this subarrays 1 to n minus n by 2 and a n by 2 plus 1 to n recursively by calling the same function Mars-Hot, and then we call the merge. Okay. So basically we have this array. Now we partition into two parts, this is n by 2, this is n by 2, I mean if n is even, otherwise it will be lower ceiling or upper ceiling. We sort this subarray recursively, and then once we got the two sorted subarray, this is sorted, this is sorted, we call merge subroutine to get a sorted array. So for merge, what we are doing, we are taking the minimum. So minimum will be here in this subarray, minimum will be here. So for this merge, we need to take help of extra array. So this is not a in place sorting algorithm. For this merge subroutine, we need to take help of a extra array if we want this merge to be in linear time. So why linear? We will come to that. So we compare these two, whichever is the minimum, we will put it here, and then we point to the next one like this, we compare like this. So this is basically time complexity for this is order of n. This is linear time, because we are just reading this. So every time we are returning, we are outputting one element. So there are n element total, n by 2 n by 2. So basically we are spending linear time for that. Okay. So and but this for this merge, we need to take help of a extra array to store this element. Otherwise we cannot store here in a linear time. Not possible to store this in a linear time. The merge can be done in the same array. Okay, that is not possible. So this is not a in place sort. So this is not a in place sorting algorithm. Okay, not a in place sorting algorithm. So this we must. Okay, so this is the thing. Now we want to know the time complexity for this. Suppose T n is the time to sort n element. Now how much time we are spending here? Here we are spending theta of 1 time. Now this is theta of n. Now how much time we are spending here? So we have a two call of same size, n by 2 n by 2 of the same merge. So it will be basically 2t n by 2. So the t n will be sum of this. So the t n will be basically theta 1 plus 2t n by 2 plus theta of n. So this theta of n and theta 1 all will combine. So this is basically 2t n by 2 plus theta of n. So this is basically the time complex, this is basically recurrence related to, this is the function related to time complexity. So this is function is called recurrence function. So this is called recurrence of this algorithm. So we got this recurrence. So basically we got T n is equal to 2 T n by 2 plus theta of n or some C of n, theta of n. So this is what is called recurrence or recurrence relation. Okay. Now the question is how to solve this recurrence. We need to get the solution. We are not happy with this type of expression. We want to know whether Mars-Hot is a order of n square algorithm or order of n log n algorithm or order of n cube algorithm or order of n algorithm. So that is of our interest. We don't So, we do not happy with this recurrence. We need to have the solution of this recurrence. So, we need to solve this recurrence. So, now the question is how to get the solution of this recurrence. Okay, so, to solve this recurrence, we can use what is called recursive tree method. So, basically we are going to solve this like theta n, we can put just c of n, some constant n. Okay, so, basically what this is, basically we have an array of size n, we divide the array into two sub arrays and then we call the merge, then we recursively sort this to sub array, then we call merge to get the solution of the whole array. So, this is our T n. So, T n is basically can be write as C n T n by 2 T n by 2. So, basically we have a problem of size n, this is what is called divide and conquer technique. So, this is a problem of size n, we divide the problem into two sub problems and then we recursively solve this sub problems, this sub problems, and this will again take T of n by 2, T of n by 2, and then once we have the solution of these two sub problems, we merge this with the cost of C n, that is called merge in the merge sort. So, that is the C n. So, this total time is basically sum of this. Now, again this is a problem, basically this is a sub problem, but this is again a problem of size n by 2. Again we can further divide it into the sub problems, sub sub problems. So, C n, so this will be again can be C n by 2 T n by 4 T n by 4, similarly C n by 2 T n by 4 T n by 4, because the sub problems of size n by 2. Now, again we further divide this when we call the merge sort on the sub problems, on the sub array, on the sub array, on the sub array we again call the merge sort. So, it will divide into sub sub array. So, like this we continue until we reach to the size 1 array, then we merge, come back and like this. Okay. So, again we further divide this into C n by 4 T n by 8 T n by 8, this is the merge cost C n by 4 T n by 8 T n by 8, this is C n by 4 T n by 8 T n by 8, this is basically C n by 4 T n by 8 T n by 8. Okay. So, this way will continue and our time complexity is sum of all this. So, this way will continue and we stop when we reach to the when n will be 1, because if it is 1 then we cannot further divide into sub problems. So, we each branch will stop. So, this is C n by 4, all will be C n by 4, C n by, sorry, C n by 8, 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 like this, and all branch will stop at T 1, T 1, T 1, like this, all branches stop with T 1, because once we reach to the T 1, that means there is the size of the problem, that sub problem is of size 1, then we cannot reduce it further, we must stop there. And that T 1 will take theta of 1 time, because we have to, if we have to solve only one element, if we have to solve only array of 1 a, that is already sorted. So, theta of 1, so all the T 1 is basically theta of 1, because if our problem size is 1, there is nothing to be done, it is already solved. Okay, so, this is basically all the branches will come like this and all the branches will stop this. Now, our time complexity is the sum of this nodes basically. Okay. So, now the question is how to get the sum of these nodes. So, T n is basically sum of all this. So, how to get the sum? We can get the sum level wise, we can get the sum of the labels and then the labels of the sum. So, if you do that, what is the sum of this label? Cn. What is the sum at this level? Cn. What is the sum at this level? Cn. If you just see, it is all the sum is Cn. Okay. So, sum at all level is Cn. Now, what is the height of the tree? So, now what is the sum of this level? Con into h. H is the height of the tree. Now, what is this height of this tree? Now, how to get height of the tree? If you observe here, this is n by 2, this is n by 2 square. So, if the height is h, then this is n by 2 cube, like this it is coming down. So, if the height is h, then n by 2 to the power h basically coming to be 1. We stop at t 1 na. So, from here we can say 2 to the power h is n. So, h is log n base 2. So, height is log n. So, this is basically C L log n. So, this is basically solution of this is L log n. So, this is the time complexity for Mach short. Okay. So, this is what is called recursive tree. So, this method is called recursive tree method. This is called recurrence tree or recursive tree. Recurrence tree or recursive tree. Okay. So, this is one way we can try to get the solution. There are some other method to solve the recurrence, what is called substitution method, that is the inductive method. In the method of induction we prove that, because see in this here, what is the guarantee that at ith level it will be C n? We are just using our intuition that it is going like C n, C n, C n. So, at the 10 level also it will be C n. But again, what is the guarantee that it at the 10 level it is C n? So, we need a proof. That proof we are not doing. So, that is why this method is not a foolproof method. So, this method is, so we have a foolproof method which is called substitution method to solve the recurrence, where we will see by the method of induction we can prove that our solution is this. Okay, so, this is the Mach short time complexity. So, now what is the what is the worst case for Mach short, what is the best case, what is the average case if we want to do? So, can you tell me the worst case of the Mach short? Or what is the best case of the Mach short? What is the best case of the Mach short? Or what is the, so what is the best case of the Mach short? So, you want to do the type of analysis of Mach short. So, like in insertion sort, we see that if the input is sorted, it is the best case, but is this the same as here? So, if the input is sorted in the Mach short, will it make any difference? If the inputs are equal element, will it make any difference? Whatever input may be, we are not caring, we are just going to the middle, we are dividing the array into two sub array, we sort them, once we get the solution, then we merge them. So, we really does not bother about the input. We are just going to the middle of the array, we are dividing it, we are sorting this part, then we are merging, that is it. So, it always recurrence will be like this for any input 2n by 2 plus theta 1, always for all type of analysis. This is the always the recurrence will be like this. So, the solution is always this. This is for all the cases, worst case there is, because all the cases are same, worst case, best case and average case also, because we really does not bother about the input pattern. We have just divided the array into two sub arrays, then we sort this sub array recursively, then we call the merge. So, this will be the recurrence in any input, for any input. Okay. So, that is the case. Now, we talk about, so, but this is a L log n time algorithm, whereas worst case, whereas the insertion sort is order of n square algorithm. So, but whichever is the better, insertion sort or the Mach short? Insertion there is a extra advantage in the sense it is a in place sort. We do not need the extra array to sort it, but merge sort is not in place. For that merge, we have a sorted array. So, this is sorted, this is sorted. After calling the recursive call, this is sorted. Now, this is, now we need to call merge. So, merge is merge subroutine. So, then we need to take help of a extra array. So, here what we are doing, we are taking the least element of this, least compare the least two element, whichever is the least among this, we are outputting there. Then we are comparing the next list like this we are doing. So, this is the merge subroutine. So, for that we need to, and merge we want to do in linear time. So, for that we need to take help of a extra auxiliary array of size n, otherwise we cannot make it in linear time if we have to handle this in the same given array. This is our A array. Okay, so, this has to be clear. So, that is why merge sort is not a in place sorting algorithm. Okay, so now we will take another example of recurrence, where we will use the recursive tree method to get the solutions. So, that is basically so, let us have another recurrence, like suppose we have a recurrence like this, T n is equal to T n by 4 plus T n by 2 plus n square. Okay. Suppose we have this recurrence and we want to. So, how form we can get this type of recurrence? Again, this can be generated by a algorithm which is again divide and conquer in nature. So, we have a problem of size n, we divide the problem into two sub problems, and here they are not equal size. One sub problem is size is n by 4, another sub problem is size is n by 2. Then once we have the solution of these two sub problems, we combine these two sub problems with a cost of order of n square. This is basically combined step or merge step. Okay. So, this type of recurrence we can get from such a divide and conquer approach. Now, the question is how to solve this recurrence. Okay. So, we will again use the recursive tree method to solve this. So, T n is basically, so we can write this as this T n by 2 T n by 4 like this. Then again this is a problem of size n by 2, and then again we can divide, oh sorry, this is say n by 4 and this is n by 2. So, again this is a problem of size n by 4. So, we can again divide into sub problems. So, then this is basically n square and this will be basically c. So, now our size is n by 4. So, we put the same recurrence. We are assuming that in the subsequent steps also we are having the same recurrence. So, it will be c, oh we do not have c here, we can put a c over here. C is a constant, if it is theta of n square we can put c of n square. So, c of n by 4 square, so that is basically n by 4 square, we can just write in this way, then it will divide into this t of n by 16. And then this is T of n by 8, and similarly here we can have, so this is n by 2, so C of n by 2 square, and this is again we put n is equal to n by 2, so T of n by 8 T of n by 4. So, basically we are further we are dividing into sub problems, sub problems with the same recurrence. Okay. So, then again we divide into sub problems. So, this is of size, this is of size n by 16. So, if we divide it into sub problems, it will be T of n by 64 and this is T of n by 32 and this will be again T of n by 32 and this will be again t of n by 16, and this will be again t of n by 16, sorry, t of n by 32, and this is t of n by 16, and this is t of n by 16, and t of n by 8, and this will be c of that square, c of this square, c of this square, c of this square, and we will continue. So, which branch will end first? So, this is going rapidly, so this will end. So, each of this branch will end with t 1. So, each of this branch will end t 1. So, this will end first than this one. So, this will be going little longer. So, everybody will end at the point t 1. Okay. Everybody will end at the point t 1. So, but this branch will end first because it is growing rapidly to this. And this is will be c of that square, 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 like this. Okay. So, this every branch will be ending with t 1, t 1 is means theta 1, like this, theta t 1 is theta 1. So, every branch is will be ending at theta 1. So, our time complexity is basically sum of the all nodes. So, now how to get the sum? So, we will get the sum level wise. Now, what is the this level sum? This is n square. So, what is the this level sum? So, this is basically what, 1 by 16 plus 1 by 4. So, this is 16. So, 5 by 16. So, this is basically c of that. So, this is c, c of 5 by 16 n square. Okay. Now, if we just calculate this, we will be getting c of 5 by 16 square n square. I mean, if we can verify this, then this will be c of 5 by 16 n cube, like this. Okay. So, this way it will be coming. So, this way it will be coming. Now, so again here we are using our intuition. What intuition? That is this like this. So, what is the at the ith level we are thinking that it will be 5 by 16 to the power I. Now, what is that proof? That proof is not we are doing here. So, either we have to prove that by method of induction or something else, then we can say this is a probable method. So, but we are not doing, we are just using the intuition. We have no patience to go up to this level after this, but we are using our intuition. Okay, it is going like this, so it will go like this. So, this is the way it is going. Okay. So, now if the height of the this is the h 1 and the height of the bigger tree is h 2, then we can say this sum, then we can say. So, up to h 1, so h 1 is the earlier ending the tree. So, up to h 1 it is bounding like this. So, up to h 1 it is a complete binary tree, and up to h 2 it is not complete. So, basically it is bounded by sum of this up to h 1 left side and bounded by sum of that up to h 2. Now, we want to take the sum of this term. So, what is the sum of this term, and what is the height basically, what is h 1? We want to get h 1. H 1 is basically, so h 1 is basically what? So, this is 4, this is 4 square, this is like this. So, 4 16, so 16 into 4, so 4 4 square is 4 cube. So, basically n by 4 to the power h 1 is equal to 1. So, h 1 is equal to basically log n base 4. Similarly, here also this is basically 2. So, h 2 is basically log n base 2, but this again we can make it into base 2. So, log 2 base n. So, this is a constant. So, height is a order of log n. So, height is order of log n. So, now we need to take the sum of this and that will be the solution. So, how to get the sum of this? So, basically, we have this sum. So, it is basically c n square into 1 plus 5 by 16 plus 5 by 16 square plus dot 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 so on. Now, this is a finite sum, but if you want to make it infinite, this should be less than, and now this is basically c of n square. This is basically this series, power series, 1 plus x square like this. Now, this is basically 1 by 1 minus x if x is less than 1. So, this is basically 1 by 1 minus 5 by 16. So, this is again a constant march with this. So, this is basically theta of n square. The solution of this is theta of n square. So, this is basically theta of n square, but again this is not a provable method, because this recursive tree method, we are assuming that all level it is going like this. So, it will be 5 by 16 to the power I at the ith level, but that proof we are not doing. So, but this is giving us an idea what could be the solution for the recurrence. So, but in the next class we will talk about probable method, which is the substitution method, where we will take help of the induction proof, method of induction, and then we will see but there we have to assume our guess. We have given a solution, we have given the recurrence, we have to assume the solution, then we have to prove the solution. So, that we will do in the next class. Thank you.